natin itong taong ito na ma-equip para sa peace na ito. But anyway, today, kasama po natin siya para tulungan ako na magbigay ng reflection sa atin sa talk na ito about identification. Brother Adrian Villa!
So are you ready to set free from all the lies of your past?
Yes!
You know, this series, I'm very excited in this series because this series will set you free. And let's read from the Bible verse for today. One of the most popular verse. Palagi ang sure, narinig niyo na to. From the book of Genesis, chapter 32, verse 24 to 31. So let's all read. So Jacob was left alone, and a man wrestled with him till daybreak. When the man saw that he could not overpower him, he touched the socket of Jacob's hip, so that his hip was wrenched as he wrestled with the man. But the man said, "Let me go, for it is daybreak." But Jacob replied, "I will not let you go unless you bless me." The man asked him, "What is your name?" "Jacob," he answered. Then the man said, "Your name will no longer be Jacob, but Israel, because you have struggled with God and with humans and have overcome." Then he blessed him there. The sun rose above him. As he passed Peniel, he was limping because of his sin. You know, this is one of the strangest stories in the Bible na nakipag-wrestling. Oh, parang nagkaroon ng WWF si Jacob with the man or with the angel or God himself. And in the process, yung habang nagre-wrestling sila, instantly, God changed the name of Jacob to Israel. Which means, yung name mismo ng bansang Israel na galing yung kay Jacob. Kasi sa kanya nanggaling yung 12 tribes of Israel, di ba? Yung mga anak niya. And ayoko nang gawing komplikado ba itong story na ito dahil marami talagang pwede pagdebatehan dito sa mga interpretation na makikita nyo sa story na ito. Pero gusto ko lang mag-stick sa core ng message ng story na ito that Jacob encountered God. Yung wrestling na yun, he encountered God, and that encountering with God changed Jacob instantly. And you know, when you meet God, you change. Kaya nga na dito sa peace eh. Sino dito yung mga matagal na nag-peace? I believe you are here at the feast because you encountered God here. Because something changed inside of you. Yes? You know, an authentic God encounter changes your perceived identity. And alam niyo ba ang pangalan ni Jacob? Jacob means grabber, manggagancho, manipulator, deceiver, magnanakaw. Diba? So, may negative connotation na kagad. At yun yung dinala ni Jacob, yung self-label niya for the longest time. Yung pangalan niya yun. At alam niyo, marami sa atin, katulad ni Jacob, na meron tayong self-imposed negative sa sarili natin. Na iniisip natin na mahirap ng lolo ko, mahirap ng din tatay ko, mamamatay lang din ako na mahirap. Na adik yung lolo, adik yung tatay ko, mamamatay din ako na ganito. Or hindi na ako pag-aaral yung buong pamilya ko, ako din, ganun. So we look down on ourselves. Yun yung negative perception natin. So, nagkaroon na ng pattern. So, ang tawag dito parang generational sin or generational curse. Na makikita nyo talaga to sa Bible, yung napapass down yung sin ng tatay sa third and fourth generation. Kung makikita, pwede nyo siya tignan sa Exodus chapter 20, verse 5. And then, pero meron akong good news sa inyo. Tanong nyo sa akin ano? You can break that curse right now when you will accept Jesus in your life. He can change you instantly, katulad ng ginawa niya kay Jacob. Kasi after na na-encounter niya si God, God changed the name of Jacob to Israel. Israel means one who struggles with God. na from struggle with men, nag-level up na si Jacob. So tinawag na siya na struggles with God. Question, do you have struggles with people around you? Meron bang mga negative, mga toxic people sa paligid nyo?
Yeah.
Yeah? Kung meron ganyan sa kapaligid nyo, sa ka-office mate nyo, kahit saan, I have a strong recommendation. Take your case upstairs. Leave it to God. Don't take matters into your hands. Surrender it to God. Hayaan mo na siya. Hayaan mo na sa pagbayan mo na siya kay Lord. Because trust Him more, He will vindicate you. He will fight your battles. He will give you the victory that you want. Siguro, all his life, Jacob was ruthless. Grabbing what he could grab. Siguro lahat na ng pasahero sa EDSA kinukuha ni Jacob kasi grab eh, di ba? So, kung di nyo na-guess yung joke on, grabe. So, yun. That encounter with God changed him. And yung wrestling match niya, na ginawa ni God, binuro ni God yung hip ni Jacob. Pinilayan siya. God broke his pride. And God gave him a limp. You know, by faith, Jacob, when he was dying, worshiped as he leaned on the top of his staff. He was leaning on his staff because of his faith. Doon sa tungkod niya, pinilayan siya ni Lord at umasa na lang siya doon sa tungkod niya. And message, you only learn to worship God when you have a limp. You will only learn to seek God, to be dependent on God if you have crisis in your life. You will only learn to be prayerful if you have problems right now. You know, kung walang limp si Jacob, kung hindi siya pinalayan ni God, aasa lang siya sa sarili niya. He will not seek God. Siguro bukaw walang Israel ngayon. And you know, maybe right now, you have crisis. You have limp in your life. You have problems. Hey, God allowed that limp for you to depend only on Him. That weakness can become your strength. So, I want to pray for you as we bow down our heads. And let's pray. Jesus, we're now standing in front of you, asking for your grace to flow into our life today. We ask you to change our self-imposed negative identity that destroy me. Lord, change me. I open myself to your word and believe that I am beautiful, that I am amazing, that I am wonderful creation, that I am made by your own image and likeness. And all this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
See you again. Bye, word.